it had rivers, it had forts, it had palaces. It was covered on all sides except one, via mountains. And the only side which was not covered by a mountain, there was a big river that they used to export crops. Tanzania had a lot of production of crops, so they exported crops to more than 20 nearby kingdoms. The people living in Tanzania were super happy with the kind of lifestyle that was given to them by their king. They worshipped him. They loved him like anything. Just like we have seen in movies, the kind of kings that you see who are worshipped by almost everybody. That was the aura of King Sumit, Samrat Sumit. This year, it was supposed that the production would be about 20 times than the last year. They tied up with a lot of other states and were planning to send the crops there. But just like fate always does unexpected things, they got famine at that particular point of time. The people went up to Samrat Sumit and told Sumit, "Sir, we need your help. This is the time of crisis." Samrat Sumit was usually calm and he said, "Everyone, we have got abundance of money. Come tomorrow and each and every one of you will be taken care of." The next day came. Everyone gathered there. Everyone was waiting for Samrat Sumit to come and help them. Sadly, Samrat Sumit didn't turn up. The people waited from the morning till the night. 2 days passed by, but Samrat Sumit didn't come. This was unexpected. People thought, how can this happen? Our beloved king is not here. Little did they know that there was a news that came to Sumit. And a person came and told Sumit that because of the famine that have happened in this state, there are 3 other kingdoms who have ganged up and would be attacking our kingdom. Now if you remember, the only way to attack the kingdom was via the river and nothing else. He told him that we just have 55 days to prepare ourselves against the war and the 3 mighty kingdoms that are coming to attack us. The only reason how we can save ourselves is by building a 500 feet tall wall so that they are not able to climb and come to our side. Now Sumit was perplexed. He had money, but he had to make a choice. First choice is to give the money to all the people in his state. And the second choice was to build a wall. He thought that in these dire circumstances, if I go to my people and tell them that this is what we are facing, they might get into more difficulty. So he thought, people will trust me, people will believe me. I just need to go and tell them that we need to build a wall without telling them why this needs to be done. People were again told and informed that now Samrat Sumit will come and talk to each one of you. But you have to come to a different venue, that is the riverside. Samrat Sumit was there at the heights. And he told everyone that instead of getting money, you people will have to work. Everyone got confused. What is happening? This was not expected. Just when Samrat Sumit was delivering a speech, he slipped. Maybe out of anxiety and depression, and he fell. And Samrat Sumit lost his voice. People thought that this is jinxed. Something that he is planning to do is not good. The gods are against us, and that is why he fell. But his son Veer knew that something is wrong. He knew that his father has a dream. He continued with his father's dream and he motivated some of the locals. It was difficult talking to them, it was difficult motivating them at that point of time, but he still managed to have a few people by his side. Days passed by. Out of 55 days, 30 days passed. Now they just had 25 days remaining, but 50% of that wall had already been built. So now Samrat Sumit and Veer thought that things are in our favor and they were happy and joyous. Like it happens in life, whenever we are happy and joyous, something wrong happens somewhere or the other. Similarly, something happened there as well. Veer was riding his horse. He fell and he lost his eyes. People said, people knew that this place is jinxed. People told him that we have already told you that this place is jinxed. What you are doing is not right. Now they were in a state of fix. Samrat Sumit didn't speak. And his son Veer didn't see. The only hope that they had were their daughter, were some Rakshman's daughter, Ragini. Now if you remember, Ragini also happens to be visually impaired. But Ragini was very good at the language that the blind understand, that is Braille. So he goes up to Veer and tells him, Veer, it does not matter. I am here and I will stand by you. I will teach you how to go through the manuals to understand everything, and now we can talk to each and everyone and tell them that this task can still be done. But the problem was that the people were not ready to follow a lady. It had never happened in their kingdom that there was a lady who was at the helm of operations. They were just not ready to do it. But Ragini had different ideas. She was confident and she had all the traits of her father. So she went up to the people and delivered one of the most fiercest of speeches, telling the people of that kingdom, if a woman can give birth to each one of you, if a woman can transform the lives of so many people, that woman can transform the future of everyone sitting here. She told everybody why King Sumit took that decision. And when people heard it, there were tears in the eyes of people. All of them got together. And finally they worked really hard around exactly 54th day, just one day before the attacks were planned. They got success. Just then, there was a king who was sitting there with a smile on his face. A saint came up to him and asked him, what did you get? You had money, you could have gone out, you could have lived a very happy life. Why did you decide to give your life to your people? What did you get? You cannot see, you cannot speak, your child cannot see. He said, I got something for which I can live my entire life. They got success, the wall was built, and their kingdom was protected. Now today, ladies and gentlemen, I have a question to each and every one of you. What is that something that you can live for the rest of your life? Is it family? Is it love? Is it work? Or is it something that drives you every single day? Samrat Sumit, his son and his daughter, had something which drove him all his life. He said, whenever this wall will be seen, I will be remembered. What is that one thing that each and every one of you will be remembered for? You need to find that something which will drive you for the rest of your life. Thank you so much.